Images of black men that are projected are consistent with the thoughts of our oppressors. And I'm so amazed that black people are surprised about the way that we're being portrayed, because we've always been portrayed that way. Of course, there were flashes. Of course, there was, you know, the Cosby Show and things like that. But I'm a big comic book fan. The X-Men were based on, you know, the struggle between Malcolm X and Martin Luther King, and there wasn't even no black men in it, you know? Spider-Man been swinging around New York for 30 years now, and he ain't been doing nothing but beating black folks' ass. You know what I'm saying? So, like, I think what has happened, though, the shift has been in us accepting and actually even wanting to portray that image ourselves is the problem.
Because the truth is, people are gonna say, well, we don't like this show, we don't like that show, but you're not gonna turn off your TV. You're not gonna stop spending your money. What are you gonna do about it is the question.
I just would like to see some balance. See, the thing is, a lot of people think that I think that there's a problem with the image of black men and women. I think that there just needs to be balance. You know, because black people are not all positive and they're not all negative. There's just a balance. But what about that other side of the spectrum? You know, and the thing that I fear is now we are creating a generation of kids who only know the negative aspect of black people, and that's what they want to be. I've never seen a population of children who want to be and like that's what they want. That's the default. I am a and I'm proud of it. What, are you serious? Where they do that at? You know? And I think that that is our fault, because our children are a reflection of what we did or did not do.
The Civil Rights Movement brought a number of societal wrongs into view by shining light on Jim Crow laws, segregation, voting rights, and discrimination in all its forms. But one troubling issue has been festering for years, and many of us literally live with it each day. Environmental injustice in communities of color is the latest battle in the fight for civil rights. From air pollution to severe weather changes, more often than not, low-income and minority communities are hardest hit by environmental hazards. Now activists want you to know about it.
You have to see it sometimes to know that it's real. And when we think about it, so many of us were impacted by these different natural disasters that have happened as of late, whether it's Hurricane Katrina or Hurricane Sandy. And unfortunately, that has been a catalyst for some people to come in and really look at their environments in a different perspective. So being able to visually see it and see how people are impacted by it is what turns young people into lifetime leaders for our environment.
Landfills, industrial factories, power plants, and oil refineries are currently being built in our backyards. But these neighbors do not come bearing gifts. They bring with them a number of life-threatening health problems.
Communities of color, especially African-American communities, are three times more likely to have a power plant in their neighborhoods. So when we think about that, it's like, where are these different pollutions coming to? They're coming right down into your neighborhood.
Decades of carefully reviewed science tells us our planet is changing in ways that will have profound impacts on the world we leave our children.
President Obama released a National Climate Action Plan to cut carbon pollution and lead the world in a coordinated assault on a changing climate.
You see extreme weather changes. We had a polar vortex, we had heat waves, we have stronger storms, we have stronger hurricanes. Those are different symptoms of climate change. And what that means is that our country has a fever. And humans are causing that fever based off of our practices. It's having the biggest flu season of our existence. But the reality of it is that our planet will be just fine. It's us. Okay? So if we don't think about what's going to happen to us, it'll be the planet and the roaches. But it will not be us. So we don't need to save the planet. We need to save ourselves.
That's the message the Hip Hop Caucus is taking to a new generation of activists. They teamed up with a host of celebrities for the Act on Climate College Campus Tour.
We have to be engaged, civic engagement-wise, so people can strengthen democracy as well, so get out to vote, so we can make sure that they also not only come to the occasion or to the event, but also go to the polls, because we gotta shape policy. And in hip-hop, either we shape policy, or policy will certainly shape us.
Participants believe that awareness of the problem is one thing, but action is what's needed now.
Pay attention around you. Know what you're digesting in your system. Know about the plants and stuff that are built directly, you know, across from you and your kids, elementary schools or high schools.
For the folks at the lowest end of the totem pole, they're going to feel it the worst. They're going to feel it the most, and they're going to feel it the quickest. For many Black folks in low-income communities, they're going to be hit the hardest. And for all of us as a Black community, we need to pay attention to that.
The time has come for the Black community to pressure elected officials to do something about our environment before our environment does something about us.
So the question is not whether we need to act. The question is whether we will have the courage to act before it's too late.
In Washington, Andre Showell, BET News.
Free City. See, shout out to every young brother, you know, who's doing his bid right now. Keep your head up. Just walking that yard, wish he had wings and just, you know, fly up out of that joint.
Man. Somehow, oh, no. Man, I really believe that I done turned it around. Oh, no. You see, all I need is that second chance to show. Since incarceration, my obligation to rehabilitation. Oh, no. Punch behind, kick me low. Oh, spin on me, it's gonna take more than that for them to break my soul. Man, it's hard for people to understand what it's like to be gated, incarcerated. Most can't take it, but I'ma make it, man, to see better days.
If I could